Are green apples healthier than red apples? Let's see what the science says in this video. Hi, I'm Chung, an accredited nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. Many people seem to think that green apples are healthier. There's a perception that green apples are less sweet than red apples and therefore might be better for blood sugar control. It's also believed that green apples contain more fiber than red apples, but how true is that claim? In today's video, I'll compare the nutritional content of green apples versus red apples and uncover whether green apples are truly more beneficial for your health. Besides sugar and fiber content, I'll be throwing in a third consideration as well, so do watch till the end. For today's comparison, I'll be using the commonly available Granny Smith green apple versus the Gala red apple. For the rest of this video, I'll simply use the terms green apple and red apple, and I'll be comparing the nutrients found in one medium apple of about 120 grams. One medium red apple has around 73 calories, while one medium green apple has around 71 calories. So in terms of energy content, there's virtually no difference between the two types of apples. Since most people feel that green apples should contain significantly less sugar due to the taste, let's take a look at this as well. One red apple contains 14.2 grams of sugars, while one green apple contains 12.7 grams. The difference of 1.5 grams of sugar is a small one and is equivalent to only about half a teaspoon of sugar. So why does a red apple taste so much sweeter than a green apple? There are two reasons for this. First is the sugar composition. The sugars in a red apple can be further broken down into 2.5 grams of sucrose, 2.4 grams of glucose, and 9.3 grams of fructose, while the sugars in a green apple consist of 1.9 grams of sucrose, 3.2 grams of glucose, and 7.6 grams of fructose. Glucose is actually about 75% as sweet as sucrose, while fructose could be 1.5 to 2 times as sweet as sucrose. As such, red apples have proportionately more of the two sweeter sugars, which is around 83% of sucrose and fructose, while green apples have 75%. Red apples therefore taste much sweeter, even though the total difference in sugars is a small one. Second is the amount of acid in the apples. A green apple could contain up to 2 times the amount of malic acid compared to a red apple. Acids have a distinct tart flavor, which further reduces the perception of sweetness in green apples. Since we're on the topic of sugars, I should also mention the glycemic index, which is a measure of how much a food would affect your blood sugar levels. The glycemic index is very similar for both green and red apples, with both types of apples having a value around 35 to 40. As such, both green and red apples are considered low glycemic foods that have lesser impact on blood sugars. So in terms of sugars, both apples are comparable in their health effects, even though red apples taste a lot sweeter. What about fiber content? Is it true that green apples have a lot more fiber than red apples? Before I get into that, if you learned something in this video, help me hit the like, share, and subscribe buttons and turn on the notifications. And if you've not already done so, you could also check out this other video where I dive into another food component that's great for heart health. Both green and red apples contain a good amount of fiber, including a type of viscous fiber called pectin that has been shown to lower LDL cholesterol. This important meta-analysis showed that consuming 1 gram per day of pectin could potentially reduce LDL cholesterol by about 2 milligrams per deciliter. This was one of the pieces of evidence that led to the 2010 European Food Safety Authority statement, which concluded that there is a causal relationship between pectin and LDL cholesterol, and that 6 grams per day of pectin could be effective in maintaining normal blood cholesterol levels. If we do the math, 6 grams of pectin per day could potentially reduce LDL cholesterol by 12 milligrams per deciliter, a clinically meaningful amount. One green apple contains a higher amount of total fiber at 3 grams, while one red apple has 2.5 grams. At the same time, studies have shown that higher acidity in apples promote the formation of pectin, with the pectin content of green apples estimated at 1.9% and the pectin content of red apples at 1.3%. This would mean that one green apple could have around 2.3 grams of pectin, which might be 44% more than the 1.6 grams found in one red apple. So in terms of pectin, green apples seem to have a slight edge. Are the comparisons for sugars and pectin enough to convince you to eat more green apples than red apples? Let me know in the comments. Let's now throw in a third consideration for the comparison. Apples are not major food sources of vitamins and minerals. However, they are an important source of natural antioxidants from plant foods known as flavonoids. There are many different flavonoids, and we'll look at three main ones found in apples today. But take note that these flavonoids are found primarily in the skin of apples. Let's first look at quercetin and epicatechin. Both quercetin and epicatechin have been suggested to increase the availability of nitric oxide, a molecule that helps with the relaxation of blood vessels, which could then help to reduce high blood pressure. These flavonoids are found primarily in the skin of apples, and their effects are demonstrated in this randomized controlled trial. 30 participants acted as their own control by consuming 2 apples per day with the skin for 4 weeks, and then switched over to consuming 2 apples per day without the skin for another 4 weeks. The participants' blood vessel function, as measured by a technique called flow-mediated dilation or FMD, was significantly improved after the 4-week consumption of apples with skin compared to apples without skin. Does this translate to improvements in high blood pressure? In this study with data from about 190,000 participants, the researchers found that having 4 servings of apples per week compared to less than 1 serving per month was associated with a 9% lower risk of developing high blood pressure. Comparing the 2 types of apples, one green apple contains 3.1 mg of quercetin, while one red apple has 4.6 mg. For epicatechin, one green apple contains 8.5 mg, while one red apple has 7.3 mg. For these first 2 flavonoids, it seems like it's a tie between green and red apples. But what about the third flavonoid that's found in apples? Before I go into that, if you enjoyed this video, it would be amazing if you could help me share it with just one other person. Cynidin is the third flavonoid that's commonly found in apples. However, cynidin is a reddish-purple pigment and is therefore found only in the skin of red apples. One red apple contains 1.5 mg of cynidin, while green apples do not have any. Cynidin has similar activity to quercetin and epicatechin and has been shown to increase nitric oxide production and improvements in the function of blood vessels. As such, with cynidin in the picture, it looks like red apples have an advantage over green apples in terms of antioxidants. Summarizing everything, green apples and red apples are very similar in terms of their nutrition content. Even though green apples contain slightly less sugar, both apples are similar in their health effects with comparable glycemic indices. Green apples have slightly higher fiber content, especially pectin, than red apples, while red apples have slightly more antioxidants compared to green apples. However, there is one final factor that we must consider, which is the enjoyment of eating an apple. I believe that for most people, it'll be much easier to include a sweet-tasting red apple rather than a tart green apple into their daily routines. If that's you, then you should definitely eat red apples and enjoy the benefits of eating an apple a day versus not eating any apple at all. And if you do want to get the additional benefits of green apples occasionally, you could use them in your cooking where they would work very well. I'm Chong from Nutrition Domus, and if you're keen to find out more about one-to-one functional nutrition counseling, where I support clients on building sustainable habits to lower their LDL cholesterol, manage their blood pressure, reduce chronic inflammation, and improve their cardiovascular health, do head over to my website, nutritiondomus.com, and sign up for a free strategy session. In the meantime, check out these other videos where I explain how you could use various foods to reduce your risk of cardiovascular disease. See you in the next video.